总统拜登12月8日表示，美国女篮明星布里尼特·格里纳在与俄罗斯的囚犯交换中获释，目前处在美国监管之下。
Well, good morning, folks, and it is a good morning. Moments ago, standing together with her wife, Sherelle, in the Oval Office, I spoke with Brittany Griner. She's safe. She's on a plane. She's on her way home. After months of being unjustly detained in Russia, held under intolerable circumstances,Brittany will soon be back in the arms of her loved ones, and she should have been there all along. This is a day we've worked toward for a long time. We never stopped pushing for her release. It took painstaking and intense negotiations, and I want to thank all the hardworking public servants across my administration who worked tirelessly to secure her release. I also want to thank the UAE for helping us facilitate Brittany's return, because that's where she landed.These past few months have been hell for Brittany and for Charlie and her entire family and all her teammates back home. People all across the country have learned about Brittany's story, advocated for her release, stood with her throughout this terrible ordeal. And I know that support meant a lot to her family. I'm glad to be able to say that Brittany's in good spirits. She's relieved to finally be heading home.And the fact remains that she's lost months of her life, experienced the needless trauma, and she deserves space, privacy, and time with her loved ones to recover and heal from her time being wrongfully detained. Brittany is an incomparable athlete, a two-time Olympic gold medalist for Team USA. She endured mistreatment and a show trial in Russia with characteristic grit and incredible dignity.She represents the best America, best about America. It is across the board, everything about her.
此举标志着冷战以来莫斯科和华盛顿之间最引人注目的囚犯交换之一。美国以俄罗斯军火商维克托·布特作为交换，绰号“死亡商人”的布特于2012年被判处25年监禁，罪名是策划非法出售上千万美元的军火。格里纳反美也将为长达数月的争端画上句号。2月17日，他在莫斯科地区机场被拘留，被指控携带含有大麻油的电子烟弹，这在俄罗斯是非法的。8月4日，格里纳因持有和走私毒品被判在流放地服刑9年。他已经认罪，但他表示犯了一个无心之过，并不是有意要触犯法律。上个月，格里纳被转移到俄罗斯莫尔多维亚地区的一个流放地服刑。自格里纳被捕以来，美俄一直在就换囚事宜磋商，包括让密歇根州企业安全高管韦兰和格里纳一起安全回家。韦兰于2020年因间谍罪在俄罗斯被判处16年监禁，他和他的家人坚称他是无辜的，美国政府也谴责这些指控是无中生有。了解韦兰获释谈判的人士表示，俄罗斯方面拒绝在没有其他俄罗斯间谍作为交换的情况下释放韦兰。美国坚称没有任何俄罗斯间谍在押，因此没有可交换的人来满足克里姆林宫的要求。此次换囚在阿联酋进行，被视为自俄乌冲突以来华盛顿与莫斯科之间最重要的外交接触，也是战争以来两国第二次公开换囚。四月份，前海军陆战队员李德在俄罗斯监狱服刑将近三年之后获释。作为交换，拜登为俄罗斯毒贩亚罗申科减刑，后者于2010年在美国被判处20年监禁，在康州监狱服刑。